The analytics business is really strong both in the field and in the lab. So a great example of a field application that we have is actually at LaGuardia Airport. We've actually deployed underwater sensors that measure baseline parameters. This data is inside of a buoy that the analytics division actually deploys and helps maintain on a regular basis. From this buoy, the data gets transmitted to an online website where regulators and the Port Authority actually monitor the data in real time, updated every 15 minutes. And they're able to take action if there are any flood events or rain events that would cause permit overages or exceedances. With water quality monitoring, many times we'll get specific requests to monitor stuff like hydrocarbons, E. coli, even kind of more rare parameters like anthrax. Generally though, with water quality monitoring, you monitor a baseline over an extended period of time. These are baseline parameters like conductivity, temperature, pH, and dissolved oxygen. And when you have a pollution event, you're going to see indicators through these baseline parameters. Generally, when there are indications, that'll trigger an event to go and take some manual sampling and better understand what's actually happening. So this is the online side of the analytics division. And this measures typically inside the plant. This collects information about ammonias, nitrates, pH, dissolved oxygen, and turbidity levels. And it feeds directly into the plant's heart or operating system to give this information to operators. Based on turbidity levels or oxygen levels, they can actually turn pumps on or off and use this for control purposes inside the plant. A typical operating plant will have these installed throughout the premises. All this information is fed to a control room where operators can look at a large flat panel display and see data come in. One thing that makes this product unique is the Sensor IQ Net. And all of these instruments actually network with one another, which make it very easy to install. And then this data is relayed back to a central display point. If a plant were to use something other than the Sensor IQ Net, they would be using a variety of single parameter instrumentation, manufactured most likely by several different companies, which greatly increases the integration cost of wiring in a lot of different instrumentation. As compared to the Sensor IQ Net, which is much easier to deploy because it can be run with a single two-wire interface around the plant.